With Bartolomeo, we can offer 12 payload slots available for any organization, be it a research organization, university, or a commercial entity.
It's something that will enhance the capabilities to perform external research on the space station, giving greater quantities of payload slots.
Our NASA colleagues from the robotics team have told us this is the most complex experiment platform they've ever seen. The handling of the data and power is done via these white avionic boxes. One is responsible for getting the power from the Columbus and distributing it to the individual payloads. They can be controlled individually so that each payload has its own power supply. Same applies for the data handling system, which is the second avionic box. With the avionic system, we acquire the housekeeping and payload data from the payload slots and send them via the Columbus telemetry system, the ISS telemetry, to the ground.
It's going to be attached to the Columbus module. It has some of the best viewing capabilities on the station, so you're out front, leading edge, RAM. It's in the sweet spot.
We wanted to study if heart-specific stem cell called cardiac progenitors can grow faster in space, and if more of them can turn into beating heart muscle cells known as cardiomyocytes. So this is the cardiomyocytes that we generated from stem cells in our lab. The stem cell cardiomyocytes have great potential to treat heart disease for both kids and adults. Stem cell therapies for repairing a heart, damaged heart, actually requires a large number of cardiomyocytes, at least 1 billion for each patient. So we need to develop more efficient ways to produce these cells than currently possible. When we combine our 3D tissue engineering with simulated microgravity, we saw promising steps towards reaching that goal. Sending the cell to space, we would like to confirm our ground-based observation.
So inside this box, we have your whole lab. We have your supply media. We have your already used media. We have pumps. We can do incubation. We have a microscope. And finally, we have a chamber that we can grow the cells in. So all this integrated, you know, in a hand-sized package is what would take a whole benchtop in your lab. We're trying a couple of new things on this flight. We're bringing these back alive. While we'll preserve some of the cells on station, is really those live cells in return to really understand what's going on and to re-understand what's going on when they reacclimate to 1G to say, you know, do we multiply the cells, but do we multiply them the right way?
So when you ask people what they want in a shower, virtually everybody will say they want more pressure. From a technical perspective, the pressure is zero. Once it leaves the pipe, there is no pressure. What they're actually feeling is the momentum of the drops hitting their bodies, right? So the momentum is the mass times the velocity. So if you can make them bigger and make them faster, when they hit you, you're gonna feel it more. So our testing we've done and proved that we can get about, feels like 3 times more water. And then also what you're getting is because it actually covers an area as opposed to just like a needle jet, which is just one little line of water hitting you, we get about a 90-95% coverage of water actually hitting you versus a typical shower head where you might have 44-66 nozzle jets hitting you is about 25%. So you get bigger area and the droplets are bigger.
So as we get a better understanding of that, how that on a microgravity works, we're hopeful that we can come up with just a tweak or do this differently, or a droplet might be circular, now we make it, you know, oblong or whatever else that will help us continue to deal with the lower flow rate and also with conserving water.
What we set out to do was to work with the National Lab to develop a platform that would allow scientists, allow us, but other chemists to carry out chemical reactions safely and efficiently on the space station. It turns out that there's not a whole lot known, or there's not been a lot of exploration of how chemical reactions behave in microgravity. If I wanted to take the system that I've built in my lab and put it on the space station, the likelihood of it behaving the same is very low. And the engineers at Space Tangle were able to essentially take the technologies that we've developed in the lab and put them into a very small box. And this system is fairly complex inside. It has a number of bags, a lot of tubing, a lot of pumps and manifolds. We can control the speed or the rate of the reaction. We can control temperature. We can control time. We control all those sort of variables, and we can do up to 18 different reactions with up to 36 combinations of reagents and start to really look at the effect of microgravity on various types of reactions.